This is Madhukar. Welcome back to yet another tutorial. Today we will discuss about how to build a CRX app from scratch. And this CRX app or CRX plugin will be useful when you're developing for forged design automation. The forged design automation currently accepts two kinds of plugins. One is a managed .NET module plugin, and other one is a console runtime extension, that is CRX. Unlike ARX or DBX app, CRX app is different. So we will see what are the libraries should be linked with the app for successful loading into the AC Core console. Okay, let us start. We will create one. We'll just launch Visual Studio 2017. Okay, just create a project. Okay, it should be dynamic. So let us name it as Hello CRX app. Okay. So just change the configuration to 64, and this file is not required for us. So what we'll do is we'll remove. Okay. Fine. So what we'll do is we will add the SDK path. So my SDK path is located here. Okay. And come here. And we need to add these four minimum required AC first 23.lib RX API for this for runtime AC core lib and ACDB 23.lib. Okay, these four are the minimum required libraries, and make sure that in your core console you should not include acad.lib. You should not include this library. This is what it makes a difference between the console runtime extension and AutoCAD runtime extension. This library differentiate between CRX and ARX. And if you want to look what all other libraries I can link, I just go to this link. I have added these links in the description of my video. So here there is a table. So whether this library is compatible with your CRX app or not. So if you see that this is a no column for CRX column. So from here, all these libraries are not compatible, or if your module is linked or built against this module, these libraries, your module will not get loaded into AC Core console, or it will not be useful for design automation. Okay, let's come back, and we will queue the path here. Okay, so we'll give the model definition file for this 2019 ACRX. Okay, let me check if this is the correct or not. Oh, this is wrong. Then okay, path exist. Okay, and another important thing which I always keep forgetting if I use from is this code generation should be non-debug. So so because I most of the times I if I use any if I start creating projects using any Visual Studio wizard, by default that will be debug. And in case we forget or forget to change this one, we're gonna waste a lot of time. So this is important. So okay, those are the minimum things. Let me build once before adding my code. Okay, there is no ACRX. So for that I will copy this code which I have. This is nothing, no fancy. I mean, this is contains only one single command, that is hello world. Just it prints hello world. So we'll add here. Let me add here. Okay. So there is another error. Okay. To make them happy, we will include tcare. Okay, and build now. Okay, another important thing is come here and change it to CRX. So this is important because console application will not recognize a DL.DL extensions. So let us clean this and build it again. Okay, our CRX module is done. So I will add another, I will just copy this one and what I'll do is I will add another text file, that is the script file. So I will make sure secure load to 0. This is important if your module CRX module is not in either a trust either of your any trusted path. To circumvent, we are setting secure load to 0 and ARX load copy and use the use for forward slashes like Unix. Or you can use of if you are want to use the backward slashes, then you need to escape them with another backward slashes. So okay, now my command is, let me check what is my command name. It's hello, hello and quit. Okay, so properties and to debug this, what I do, I will launch so I will use the switch. A full path. use this startup switch, AC core control switch to load the script file. Okay. Build is not required. Let us see. I'll just put a breakpoint here. If everything goes fine, it should get hit. Yes. Hello world. It's working. So what we'll do, we will do one more test. SQL console secure load again. Yes, just Rx load. Okay, let me copy this. So hello world. So this is one way, or you can use another way also, AC core console. So secure load will check, yes it's zero. You can do one thing, arx load, and give this path. So there are two ways, either you can use a Lisp kind of thing, arx load, or you can use direct arx and load. Okay. Okay. Okay, this this is one interesting thing. Thank you. And here I have some resources for you, and if you want to know how to build a design automation sample for and plugin development using AutoCAD, I will recommend to go through this tutorial which I have written. So let me show. So I mean this, if you look at this, how to modify models, it's a nice tutorial from the beginning to the and complete a design automation package. And this prepare plugin, it will shows how to create a .NET module to run within a AC core console or Forge design automation. Please go through it. So if you look at this, so end of the tutorial, this is what you're going to achieve. So basically it has a dynamic block references using the width and height. Whatever the user enters the width and height, you will be modifying the dynamic block reference of the drawing. So you will choose a drawing file from your local store, local disk, and enter the width and height, and you'll issue an activity which contains your plugin logic, that is update drawing param activity. So the code of this can be found here in the prepare plugin. You just select inventor, and this is a very straightforward code which I'm doing. I'm just changing, updating the dynamic properties for a given dynamic block in the given drawing. Okay. So this is another blog which I discussed already. So if you want to know which libraries are compatible with CRX, and this is a quick reference.